on, hurry!
Hey, don't! No, don't!
You're all idiots! She's just one woman and you let her escape! Bring her back here. Don't stop until you find her. You understand?
You don't have to worry. You're safe here in my house. Take a seat.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your help, but I have to go.
Jennifer, the doctor told me that you're pregnant. You have to rest. You can stay here.
Sorry, but I really do have to go.
Why? Because you're a fugitive? I already know that, Jennifer, but I don't care. I can just let you leave, especially in your current condition.
Why are you doing this?
After the cockfight where you lost the game for the mayor, I had a heart attack. You get what you give, Jennifer. Everything has a price. But I count myself lucky. I was given another chance to make a big change in my life. I want to make things right. Jennifer, allow me to help you.
Mother and uncle are looking out for us now, baby. We can stay here for now. It would be much better for you. We can look for your father later. Mother needs to get enough rest. I will fix this mess for us.
Adrian,
you look awesome, Adrian.
Here, I'll put some hair gel.
Mother?
It's very important to look good when you're looking for a job. Remember, first impressions last.
Good afternoon.
Okay.
Gina, Adrian.
Huh? Hey, Eddie.
I came here to apologize for what I did to you, Adrian. I know now that it really wasn't your fault, and that it was just an honest mistake. So I'm asking you if you can still come back to work for me. Would that be okay with you?
Yes, of course.
Okay, that's great. Thank you. I really need people like you.
Thank you, Eddie.
No sweat. Can you start tomorrow?
Yes, tomorrow.
I'm counting on you.
Yes.
I'll be going now, Gina. Bye.
Oh, thank you.
Did you hear that, Mother?
Oh, thank you.
I don't have to beg in the streets. They know I'm good for the job, that's why.
You're the best, Adrian. Come on, give me five.
Thanks.
Madam, your father has already arrived.
Father, I brewed this coffee for you.
Newspaper, please.
Any exciting news today?
What do you want, Nicole?
Father? About the flower garden?
Yes, I know. It's a flop.
I'm so sorry. I know that you're disappointed. But I'm already thinking of new ways to make a comeback. Maybe a new marketing strategy with a good one.
Don't bother, Nicole. You're out of the flower garden. I'm assigning Hillary to manage it.
But...
Nicole, you know that it's your mother's favorite business. Do you think I'd just leave it in a mess? I gave you a chance and you blew it. If you want a new business, just send me your proposal. Money's not a problem. I'll give you the capital. But you're definitely out of the flower garden.
All right, my good friend. Thank you for your time.
So, can he help me with my case?
Jennifer, I've already talked to every lawyer that I know. We will not have any problems about your drug possession case. But the real problem is your escape from jail.
But I only did that because the mayor was going to kill me.
We know that, Jennifer. Maybe we can prove that in the courtroom. However, there is no bail in breaking out. They would surely take you back to prison. And when you're back there, Jennifer, I really can't do anything to protect you. The mayor wants you dead. Jennifer, let's start looking for our other options. Maybe we can...
Why do I always end up at the losing end? All I want is to have a normal life for me and Adrian. For our baby. Is that too much to ask for?
Break time, let's go.
Come on.
Okay, let's go. Come on.
All right.
Adrian, let's go. Let's eat.
I know a good place down the street.
He's right. And the shopkeeper's cute.
You two can go ahead. I have to finish this.
We know, Adrian. You don't need to look for a girlfriend. You already have one.
He's right. She's rich and really pretty. Even the boss agrees. He was speechless when she talked to him.
You know, gambling has become my obsession. It's hard to break the habit.
And it gets us into trouble.
I'm sorry, Jennifer. I didn't realize that I messed up your life. I've asked my people to look for Adrian, and your uncle as well. But we can't find them in your province. I'm really sorry, Jennifer. I didn't expect that it would turn out like this.
It's not your fault. I made the decision. I really thought that it would make life better for me and Adrian. I was wrong. Now I lost everything.
That's not entirely true. You still have your baby. Think of it this way. You're still the winner. Look at me. I may have everything, but my very own son won't even...
Oh my, look at this chair. Good evening, Nicole.
Hello, anything I can do for you?
Why do you have to pay for my debt at work?
Nicole, you don't owe me anything. Could you just stop bothering me with your help? If you want to reach out to charity, if you want to feel good about yourself, then don't use me.
Why, Adrian? What did I do wrong?
Every time you offer help, you make me feel that I'm a helpless blind man, that I'm useless. Pride is the only thing that I have. Do you understand? Or do you want me to explain this again for you to finally get it?
All right, Adrian, I get it. But I hope that you also understand that all I wanted to do was to help. That's it, plain and simple. I have no bad intentions, so please, don't even think that this is all just about me.
Don't you think you were a bit too hard on Nicole?
Mother, she insulted me. Who wouldn't get mad at that?
Okay, but think about it. She paid for your hospital bills. She offered you money. She got you back to work. So, what's insulting about that?
I guess I was wrong all along.
Adrian, all that I'm saying is that there is too much anger in you. And I feel that you're taking it out on people. This anger that you're feeling right now ever since Jennifer left you.
Look, I do understand why you're saying all of that. But I won't believe you unless Jennifer shows up and tells me personally. Because I know her.
Adrian, I really don't want to see you like this, just because of that woman. If you don't want to believe me, then it's okay. It's your heart talking. But it's not right to take out your anger on other people because it's simply wrong. It's just wrong, Adrian.
Jennifer, look at this. Try this on. They all look so nice. Corporate girls, eat your heart out. This one? Is this an eyelash? Green? Nice.
I don't need that. I need some kind of disguise. Not that kind. Come on now. I might end up looking like a hooker if I wear that. Hey,
I think it's cute. Think about it. You can catch the policeman's attention. How about this earring? Try it. See, it's dangling. It looks nice. So what kind of disguise do you want? Nobody would recognize you.
Ow. What? Does it look good on me? Do I look beautiful?
Hey, just hurry up. Adrian has been waiting for you. But...
How do I look?
But why are you wearing makeup? Don't tell me it's Shirley's idea again.
Come on now, Al. Adrian is just so handsome. I don't want to look like his old maid when I'm with him. I don't want to hear anybody say bad things about us, that we're not a perfect match. I don't want that to happen, you know?
Wow, you look beautiful. You know, we should get married every day in front of Al so you will always look that pretty.
You're too young, and this isn't even a real wedding.
Well, this is much better, so that when we get to our real wedding, we don't have to practice, right?
Hey, stop staring into empty space. I have something here to show you. How about this? Yes, you can cover your face with that so that you're totally disguised. See, they won't recognize you. Say goodbye to Congressman when you leave, okay? Your Prince Charming is waiting for you. I wonder, is there anybody who'll be waiting for me? I don't need a disguise.
Congressman.
Sir? What's that noise? Let's go.
Congressman?
Hurry up, Jennifer!
Congressman!
Hurry! Sir?
Congressman!
Cerner!
What happened?
Call the doctor!
Get the nurse!
No, hurry! Call
the
nurse!
Hurry!
Hurry!
Call the nurse!
Congressman!
Hurry!
Congressman! Doctor, how is he?
He had a stroke again. Now he's stable, but I think his days are numbered. He is far too weak.
Are you really sure that we don't have to bring him to the hospital?
That might trigger another heart attack. He really doesn't like hospitals. I think it's better that we prepare ourselves for the worst. He has asked for his son, Benicio.
Oh no, would that help? That boy might cause the death of Sir.
Hey, don't say that. I bet that this'll be the moment that we've been waiting for. It's the right time for their reconciliation, right?
Don't count on it, Goldie. Stop dreaming.
I think I need a vacation.
What do you say, Tatum? $3 a day. You'll just take me around the city so that I can look for work. It's hard to remember the ins and outs of the city.
Adrian, you're right. It takes more than 10 times to finally get the hang of it. But $3 doesn't sound enough. Raise it to $5 and you will have a deal.
All right, it's a deal. But you have to wake up early. Mm-hmm. I can only look for work in the morning because I also have to be working at night.
Wow, looks like you'll be busy tonight, Adrian.
I just realized that you're right, Mother. I need to fix things in my life. Do you know what I plan to do? I want to save enough so I could see again. When that happens, it will be easier to look for Jennifer.
Madam, you have a visitor.
Adrian.
Hey, good morning.
Morning.
The reason we came here is to apologize. Now I know that you really mean well. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm sorry too, because I will not accept your apology. After insulting me like that? You think an apology and some flowers will do the trick? No way! And you brought the wrong color for the flowers too.
All right. I'm sorry for bothering you then. Let's go, Tatum.
Hey, wait a minute. All right. I accept your apology.
Myrna, can you get me the magazine from the library?
Yes, sir.
Sir, let me do that for you. I'll handle this, Congressman. Your hands are shaking. Are you okay?
Benicio is coming. Did you know? How do I look? Do I look sick?
No. You just look pale. But you have to hide your hands so that it won't be too obvious.
I really don't know what I should be afraid of. Should I be afraid that he takes pity on me? Or see no sign of concern at all over my condition? I made a lot of mistakes as his father. And I understand how he resents me. This might be my chance to ask for forgiveness.
He's upstairs.
Sir.
Benicio, my son.
I heard that you're dying. I may have come too early. Here I thought that I'd be attending a funeral.
I'm sorry to disappoint you.
Is that really your son? Why does he talk like that?
Please, leave him be.
Let me have that. Colors have meaning, especially for flowers. Did you know red means anger? But don't worry, when this gets mixed up with the rest of the flowers, it means that they're okay.
What about white roses?
It means eternal love.
I didn't know that flowers hold special meaning.
Great, isn't it?
How did you know that?
I got it from my mother.
I'm sure that you love your mother a lot.
Right. But she already passed away. But it's okay. There are times that I really miss her. But it's different when it comes from my father. He's always thinking about her. I always catch him in a daze looking at her picture. Now, he's different. He's no longer the happy person that I know. I want to help him, but he won't let me. He wants to be left alone. All by himself.
That's the problem with giving everything to the one you love. When that person leaves you, all that you have is taken away.
Oh, wait. We're getting way too serious here. How about some snacks?
Sure.
All right, let's go.
Goldie, does his son really act that way towards him? When Benicia talks to him, he sounds like he's not his son. It's not just anger that he feels for him, but hatred.
Come on. Sir Benicia's really like that. That's what rich kids do. But of course, I could be the key to their reconciliation. I just could see it. In all the newspapers, it was I who made it all happen. The woman who patched things up between father and son. Let's just see if this won't turn the heads of my neighbors in the province. They should just watch out.
Sir, we received report. The name he gave was Ruben Castillo.
You owe him a visit. You know what to do.
Did you see that, Jennifer? He was checking me out. It must be the eyelash. Oh, no.
You'll need $300,000 for your treatment. This includes doctor's fees, hospital fees, pre-operation and post-operation therapies. You'll be spending a lot to get this done. Are you ready for this?
I'll find a way, Doctor. I have already asked help from charities and I've started saving up for this.
Are you sure about this?
I still have a chance to see. I need to see.
Jennifer, you almost scared me to death.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just waiting for Benicia to come out. I'll be cleaning the house, and I just need some inspiration.
What's he doing there?
I don't know. It's only Kevin and Anthony who can enter that room. And when Sir Benicio's here, he sometimes locks himself up there.
Goldie, stop that. He might be sleeping. It's rude, you know.
Sleeping?
Slowly now. Do you want some juice?
Jennifer, can you hand me the paper?
Okay, sure. Do you still want some fruits?
Scam and corruption are always on the news. depressing, right? Right, Jennifer?
Sir, we received report. The name he gave was for Ben Castillo.
You owe him a visit. You know what to do.
Jennifer?
I'm warning you, Chuatoko. I have a personal score to settle with that woman. Whoever's helping her will be in big trouble. I'm telling you. This is personal.
You won't find her here, Mayor. Jennifer. Limbaga.
Hurry, lock the door.
Okay, here, it's locked.
Look at this closely and read it.
I can't understand it. Jen, I only reached grade 3, and my father asked me to stop. He said that it was just a waste of money. That's the reason why I couldn't even read a single word. It might take all night for me to finish.
Ruben Castillo. Do you remember? We heard that name the other day from Benicio.
Oh my goodness, my sickness, my health! Oh my goodness!
Stop that!
Why?
Do you want to see your name in the next newspaper?
No. Sir Benicio can't do that to me. To other people, I guess, but when it comes to me, I don't think that can happen at all.
Oh, well, it's up to you, Goldie. Just remember, okay? We didn't see or hear anything, all right?
Adrian? Adrian, what's wrong? Adrian? Adrian! Adrian, what's happening to you? Are you sick? Adrian! What's wrong with you? Adrian! Adrian!
It's a good thing that the doctor is still here. He's just in the operating room. Just wait for him, okay? Here's your medicine.
You.
Here. You can take it now.
Thanks, nurse.
Wow. Okay, here's some water. There. All right. Are you okay, sir?
Thank you.
Okay.
Tatum?
I've been wanting to ask you, Adrian. Why didn't you tell Mother and I that you need to have eye surgery as soon as...
I don't want you and Mother to worry about me.
But what if you don't get your eyes treated? What if you're left totally blind?
No. Nothing will change. Tatum, come here. You have to promise me, okay? That Mother won't hear any of this, all right?
Why?
I didn't want people to look down on me. And I don't want to be a burden to Mother.
Okay, I promise.
Thank you. Don't worry. You know I'll come up with something. Promise.
Okay.
Tatum, here's your food for the day. Don't eat everything, okay? Leave some for your
yes,
brother.
Mother. I'm not that hungry anyways.
Hey, Nicole, how are you?
Good. I just wanted to pay a visit.
Oh, well, Adrian's on his way out. He's actually looking for work. He wants to do more aside from working at the factory. My son is a real hard worker.
Really? Do you mind if I join you? I'll be your driver for the day. That will save you money for transportation.
No need. We'll be okay.
Come on, I have nothing to do for today. Please?
Oh, looks like I have more people in my payroll. But I can only offer some sodas as payment.
Oh, that will be all right, son. I made sure that you have enough food for the day.
That will be
you
okay.
You can just share.
Great.
Okay.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Okay.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Bye.
Bye.
And singing. Maybe you could join them. Let's go, Nicole.
Okay.
Let's watch.
No, let's leave here. I don't know how to sing. Let's go.
Could you?
Yes?
Could you get the anchovies from the pantry, please?
Yes, madam.
Thank you.
Nicole, I got a call from the office. You had somebody apply in our company by the name of Adrian Toisin?
Oh, yes, father. He's a friend of mine. He really needs to get a job right now.
We don't have openings for blind people. Don't waste your time.
But, father, you know, you'll be surprised when you meet him. He's really good, father.
He can't read. He can't write. What will he do in our company? Why don't you use your head, Nicole?
At least Adrian I can talk to. How about you? You never even let me finish a sentence. You're really amazing.
It's getting late. Why are you here?
Nothing. I just have nothing to do. Can I stay here for now? Do you want me to help you? Do you? Oh, never mind. I might be bothering you. No, it's okay, really.
No, it's easy. You can do this. Come. I'll be teaching you, okay? I'll get a new one. So tonight, you will learn how to make pot.
Goldie.
Ah! Goldie! Goldie! Goldie!
Are you hiding from someone?
No one. But you. I mean, it's nothing, sir. I was just shocked after watching a horror film. I was scared. It was scary. And it's dark, you know? I easily get scared and I just get so surprised. That's all. I'm so sorry, sir.
Just continue to dream on. We Chuatoko men have high standards when it comes to our women.
There you go again. You're just his fourth cousin. You don't even look like him.
He's still my cousin. I'll tell him you said that.
Mm.
Oh, oh. I'm really telling him.
Go ahead. You're his relative, but you're still his lackey. You don't even look like him. Oh!
Hey!
It's hopeless. I can't do it anymore. It's so hard. I give up.
You're not letting it move on its own. You're forcing it to do too many things at once.
What? What do you mean?
Just close your eyes.
Why? Why do I need to do that?
So that you'll understand. Are you feeling it? Mm-hmm. See? It moves on its own. You don't fight it. Just let it move. That's when you mold it. You don't have to think. Just let your hands express what you're feeling inside. Sometimes, our hands can listen much more than our ears. Just listen. Learn to really feel what's inside your heart.
Are you taking care of my father?
Yes. He needs someone to help him, especially now. He
has his own nurse. He doesn't need you.
You can't just bar orders at anyone.
You'd better leave.
The congressman took me in, so only he can make that decision and not you. Sorry, but I'm not afraid of you. I know the dirty things that you've been doing.
You don't know what I'm capable of, Jennifer Limpaga.
Did I just do that? Let me see.
Hey, wait. It has to dry up. It might get out of shape.
This is great. This is unbelievable. It's beautiful. Can I just buy it as a remembrance, please? If I'm out of business again, I can just get a job here.
Come on now. You'll have your own business.
I hope so. It wouldn't matter at all to my father. I bet that he won't be that supportive.
Wait. Why don't you just work for your father? That way you'll be together. You'll have a chance to get close to him. Even if it's only at work. Then maybe who knows?
Adrian, I can't even take care of my small business. I don't know.
Then you can start from the bottom. Then learn as much as you can. You're a fast learner anyway. Look at your masterpiece. It just took a while to do that. See, you're better than me. I might even end up losing my job because of that. So?
We have a sketch of the woman we're looking for.
What are you doing here?
Excuse me. Good morning, sir. We got a call from your son. Our team is looking for a woman named Jennifer Limbaga.
You won't find her here.
Oh, really?
Are you sure, Father?
You just got here. Maybe you're mistaken.
I don't make mistakes, Father.
Oh no, sir. We need to take you upstairs. You'll need some oxygen. Sorry, Sir Benicio. He just needs to rest. Please excuse us. Sir? How are you feeling?
Lucky. I just escaped from another stroke. It's just good that I'm still alive.
Sorry that I have to drag you into this.
Jennifer. No, you're the one caught between my fight with Benicio.
I don't want to see you suffer.
You're suffering as well. I don't want you to go. But I can't do anything about it. You're like a daughter to me, Jennifer. I don't want to see you suffer. When I'm gone, I won't be able to protect you from Benicio. I think it's better this way. Myrna.
Yes, sir?
Please get my checkbook.
That won't be needed. You've already done a lot to help me.
Oh, please don't refuse my help. You need money. Give this check to my secretary. She'll encash it for you. It would be very hard if you don't have money. Somehow, in this way, I can help you.
Thank you.
Jennifer, do you really have to go?
Goldie, I have to.
What's going to happen to you? But it's still dangerous for you out there.
Don't worry, I can do this. Just go. You can go back now.
Take care, okay?
All right, bye. I'll be okay. Now go.
Bye.